Hi and welcome to Buzzard Exploration. Today we're at Speeton on the northeast coast of North Yorkshire in the UK. Very local to us. I'm actually walking backwards, so if I fall over don't laugh, because the sun is right above me, in front of me, and it's just easier to film it this way. We're looking at, there's a pill box on the hill which we're going to film with the drone, and I'm just going to look at the cliffs, and there's a couple of guys paragliding. Probably have a look at those as well. Ziggy Zoo's with us, Coop's with us, Andrew's here. There's a few obstacles, a few stiles to go over, but anyway, hope you enjoy the video. just approaching the cliff edge, so if it's a bit windy, I'm sorry. And here's the view from this seat here. So we've walked down the hill and to the concrete seat here. We've filmed the pillbox on the hill up there. There's another pillbox just there. These are the defence blocks on the beach that you've probably seen in other ones of our videos. These are the anti-tank blocks, great big long line at the bottom of Speeton. And then there are shipwrecks, but the tide's actually coming in at the moment. And then further round you can actually walk along the white stones, the chalk, right round for about another 2 or 3 hours at low tide, obviously. There's a couple of shipwrecks at this side, and then there's a submarine a bit further on, a World War I submarine, which is quite interesting, which I'm hoping to go on video at some point. I'll just zoom in and give you an idea of the wildness of this place. So this chalk piece of cliff goes all the way out to what we call Flamborough Head, which if you look on a map of the UK on the east coast of Yorkshire is the sticky out bit, to use a technical term. All this area down here is all wild. You quite often see deer. There are obviously crows, pigeons, all sorts of different birds live in this environment, but it's obviously there's a pond down there that will probably have something in it, frogs or whatever. And there's a track goes down here, and then you can actually climb down the cliff onto the beach there. This pillbox here at this side, which I'm going to zoom in on for you, risking life and limb, you just see the top of it poking through the edge of the wood there. That pillbox there is in one of our previous videos. This wood is actually called bull tongue wood. It's a long thin wood, and it's been called bull tongue wood. And that pillbox there, on the top of it, you can see a green patch which is grass. But around the edge of that, when the concrete was wet in 1941, all the guys that built it put their names in it, which is quite cool. So we'll hopefully get to that at some point and show you that. Just show you the defence blocks, which obviously we've shown in one of our other videos. And there's somebody walking along there. They'll probably be coming up this footpath, I would imagine, with the tide coming in. There's a long line of blocks, and then just out to sea, I'll just zoom out a little bit, just out to sea, opposite more or less the end block, which is there, somewhere here, is the wreck of the Laura, which is also in one of our videos. So there's quite a lot of history down here. And then the cliff here is the grey clay there. That's the fossil-bearing clay, where you get fossilers coming down and chipping away at it. And there was actually a plesiosaur, minus its skull, more or less complete, found. And that is now in the Rotunda Museum at Scarborough. The bay sweeps round, as you can see, to the end, which is Filey Brig. That's the town there, that's Filey. And then we come round, and you should be able to see a very white house. Just let me see if I can zoom in on it. There, that's known as the White House, that one in the middle of the frame there. And at the other end of there, those row of houses, there used to be a hangar, an aircraft hangar, dating from 1910, on the actual cliff top.
and there was a ramp, a concrete ramp, coming down to the beach at that point. And Sir Robert Blackburn in 1910 used to fly primitive aircraft, or test primitive aircraft, along the beach. One of the pioneers of flying in the UK. And the hangar, about 10 years ago, maybe 12 years ago, I actually found the hangar still existed in a little village called Hunmanby, which is where I live. It's about 2 miles inland. And we actually managed to save that hangar, and that hangar now is at the Yorkshire Air Museum. So another piece of aviation history that's been saved and preserved.
Up the hill, Coop. We did it. All the heathers out. And that wood there is Bulsung wood, where the pill box is. We're not as fit as we used to be. How are we, boys? Hey up, cocking our legs up again.
Ground's dry though, isn't it? The ground is really dry. I say it's March. There's the parachute plane again. That's the parachute plane from the parachute training centre near Grindle. It's over every weekend when it's decent weather, throwing people out of it. back to Speeton Chapel.
So thanks for watching. Please subscribe, give us a thumbs up, press the notification bell, and we'll see you in the next video. Thank you.